Hello and welcome to Backyard Food Guide. What I'd like to do today is to talk about this beautiful cabbage that we've grown. It is a 4-pound red cabbage, and the original plant that we harvested looks like this. So as you can see, it was really massive, over 3 feet wide, and we've been watching the plant grow and nurturing it. It has taken quite a long time. In fact, cabbage actually is a good plant to start very early indoors, approximately 6 to 8 weeks before last frost. And you can actually start hardening them out into the outdoors even before last frost. So it's a good idea to actually start hardening them about 3 weeks after you've planted the seed. And then about a week or two after that, you can actually put them right into the garden. So timing the planting for 2 to 3 weeks before last frost is a good way to go. Cabbage is also an ideal plant to sow in the late summer as well, so that you can get a late fall crop. So probably mid to late summer, you can put seeds right into the garden. Seeds should be planted about, or the plant should end up being about 12 to 24 inches apart, depending on the variety of cabbage that you're using, and then eventually making sure that they have good spacing. Cabbage is a heavy feeder, so you want to make sure that you have soil that is well composted, and to also make sure that you fertilize throughout. So approximately 2 to 3 weeks into the planting, you're going to want to fertilize, and then every week after that, it's a good idea. Cabbage takes up a lot of nitrogen in the soil. So the maturity time, as I've mentioned, depending on the variety, can take quite a long time. So anywhere from 80 to 150 days. So this red cabbage that we've grown took about 120 days. And you can check whether or not it's ready for harvest by checking the firmness of the cabbage. So as it's becoming more dense on the inside, if you kind of give it a squeeze, it should feel quite firm all the way through before it's ready for harvesting. So in order to harvest, you can just cut at the base by using a large knife. It is also possible to get a second crop if there's still time in your growing season. And in order to do that, what you can do is just cut out the inner cabbage part and you leave the large outer leaves and the roots. Often the cabbage will then go on to grow 3, maybe even 4 or more other sprouts. What you want to do is make sure that the second crop doesn't have more than about 3 different heads. And you're going to want to harvest those when they're about tennis ball size. So if they get too big, they're not going to work. And chances are you're not going to have much more time in terms of weather to get anything bigger than a tennis ball. So once you've harvested the cabbage, it's a good idea to soak it, because at the very base, different pests, dirt, slugs could end up in your cabbage. So what you do is you just get a large pot and soak it overnight. You could also even add about a teaspoon of salt to kind of encourage the critters to come out of the tightly bound leaves that are in the cabbage. So the best way to store cabbage is, of course, in the fridge. You can just wrap it tightly in a plastic bag, and it should last in the fridge for 2, even 3 weeks. For people who don't have root cellars, and in our climate, it's not suitable for a root cellar to store vegetables. So if you're in a climate that is freezing or just below freezing throughout the winter, then that's an ideal place to set up a root cellar, whereas our climate is a little bit warmer than that throughout the winter, so a root cellar isn't really an option for us. So what you can do with cabbage is to freeze them, And you can either cut them into quarters and freeze immediately. If you do that, they'll last about a month in the freezer. A better way is to actually blanch them first. So what you could do is boil a big pot of water, and once the water has boiled, you could just put the cabbage quarters right into the water and let it blanch for about 3 minutes. Pull them out and let them dry a bit. Once they've cooled and dried, you could flash freeze them. So what you do is put the quarters onto a cookie sheet separately so that they don't stick together, and you could pop that into the freezer. Once they've have frozen individually, you can then put them into freezer bags. And you can either freeze it all together or into separate portions, depending on how you want to use the cabbage throughout the winter. So, frozen cabbage can work well in soups and other kinds of dishes. They're probably not as ideal for things like cabbage rolls, where you need large intact leaves to be together. But in terms of taste and quality, for the most part, freezing works really well. Cabbage is a cruciferous vegetable and is quite susceptible to a number of different pests. The bugs tend to really like it. So it's a good idea to make sure you practice crop rotation with cabbage. So you want to make sure that you plant it in one spot in your garden, and if you're going to plant it again in the spring, then choose a different location just so that you can get rid of some of the bugs that might have developed specifically to the cabbage during that time. So, I hope you enjoyed the video and have learned some good tips on growing cabbage. Please give us a like and subscribe. Thank you.